Hello guys, good afternoon. Today it's all about hydrangeas. So I'll be pruning like 5 different varieties I have in the garden. And it's really very important to know which varieties you have because they have to be pruned accordingly. So let me just get changed and then I'll start pruning. Let's start cutting my hydrangeas, pruning. And it was raining and snowing and was very cold. It's still very cold, but it's okay. So what I'll do is just cut the hydrangea, this is the Annabelle, halfway. I can also cut it all the way down, but I'd prefer it to grow a little bit higher to the back, so I'll do that. Just cut off half of it. And also the weak stems that are growing. That's what I'll do. And hopefully I can finish the other ones because they are having new buds now. I don't want to ruin it. This is a limelight over here, and I don't like to cut it all the way down, but just form it a little. A lot of hydrangea climber that I have, Anomala pectoralis, and I didn't have time to prune it in fall, so I have to be very careful not to take or prune the buds that are coming out because that's where the flowers will be. Maybe down there I have to take some out, but the higher stems can stay. Nobody will get bothered with it. So. this is the hydrangea macrophylla, and I would usually take off the weak stems, but I left it last year, and I like it better because I have different sizes of the flowers. So there were smaller ones and bigger ones, so it's just a matter of preference, I guess. So what I did was just take off the dried flowers where the healthy buds are, up to the healthy buds. The flowers will come out from the old wood. That means if I take it down, then I will have less flowers. And it's been here for probably 15 years now, and it keeps coming back. So it's not really a hardy, but sometimes it gets damaged from the late frost in April. But all I do is just cut it, the frozen tips again. But it looks healthy. And just like the other one, this the flowers of this macrophylla also come out from the old wood. That's why I don't trim it all the way down. This is the hydrangea climber I have. It's the Anomala petularis. And like the macrophylla, the flowers also come out from the old wood. This is a paniculata, and as you can see, I trimmed it really low, and the flowers come out from the new wood, so it's okay to cut it really low. Just like the arborescence, the Annabelle. This is the arborescence, and actually you can even cut it lower, very low, all the way to the ground. But I prefer it to grow it a little higher here to the back, so I just left it. And the flowers will come out from the new wood, so it's okay to trim it all the way down. So this is the hydrangea quercifolia. And all I did here was just taking the dead branches, dried dead branches, and it should be okay. It usually do well here and give us a lot of beautiful flowers in around June, July. So I will be fertilizing all my hydrangeas now with a special kind of fertilizer for hydrangeas. So we'll be expecting a lot of blooms around June, July. So guys, if you like to see the flowers, you can just subscribe, and I'll be making the videos as soon as the flowers come out. Bye.